The last video about Proteus, I want to show you how it really works, how it protects the user, how it controls the temperature, videos that I have never showed you before, and how we can put the weak wire combo if it is required something special, and all this stuff. I will make the experiments with a big battery. I put on a Stericon in case someone thinks that the small battery works, but the big battery doesn't work because it gives a lot more power. So I will make the experiments with a lot of power that a big battery gives. It is full charged. 1 minute to show you. Okay, 4.13. I have put the magnet too, something that may bring problems. I don't think so, but anyway, magnet is not the way for it to work. Okay. Let's make an atomizer. We will set up Telemachos. I will make a coil at 2.7. 2.7 axis, let's measure it. No, it's 2.4. Titanium grade NA wire, its standard is ASTM B863. That's the right titanium wire forever. It's 0.32 millimeters. And first of all, I have said before, I will say it again, because this thing that I will tell you will save you a lot of problems. There are two things you have to know. The first thing is that it's better on GG atomizers to make the coil not like screwing a bolt, but like unscrewing a bolt, the opposite way. I mean like this. It's better to make more than eight coils. In that case, you will avoid hot legs, because the length of the coil is much bigger than the small legs of the wire. I mean the distance between the coil and the posts. That's a usual wire. Okay. I have moved a little the posts of Telemachos. They are not. You see that they are more close to the channels. That way we avoid big legs between the posts and the coil. That means that the coil is very close to the posts. I mean this distance between the coil and the post, this small thing, is really small, and it will not get red hot and give you a burnt taste with beer. Make the coil, screw, put around the screws the wire, one, two. Also, that's an opportunity to show you how easy you can make a coil on a Telemachus. The resistance that you have to make is more than 0.4, because beer can handle resistances from 0.4 to 2.2. Screw well these bolts, because we need good connections for beer to let it work exactly as it has to work. As you see, this is a usual coil. We didn't do something special, except that, and because Telemachus has the ability to move its posts, we move it in a way, we turn them in a way that the legs of the coil, now we can hear clear the legs. When I say the leg of the coil, I mean this distance of the wire, this. Excuse me. This is very small now. Let's put some wick. Make a wick as usual. If you make it tight on the coil, it would be better. It seems okay. Let's see if the wire touches the posts. Now with camera zoom, we have the opportunity to do that. It's okay. To have a better fitting on Telemachus, I put wicks like this before I cut them. So I cut them more if I had leave them like this, because I would have leave 1 millimeter distance between the housing and the wick. But like this, you can cut it almost flush. Put the wick inside the channel and you're okay. The first experiment, let me say it in a different way. Making an experiment and trying to see if an electronic device, a temp device, can burn a wick that doesn't have liquid on it. It's not an experiment that bothers anyone, because this will happen only when your wick is totally dry, and I don't think that anyone will let his wick go totally dry. But in case
that someone be in this situation. He has to avoid the burnt taste that is disgusting, and of course it brings a lot of acrolein, formaldehyde and acetaldehyde to your body. And because a guy on a forum, on GG forum, told me what Vir can do to a totally dry wick when other temp devices burn it. I found a way to not burn the wick even if it's totally dry. We will do the experiment, as I told you, with a big battery. And of course, we will do the experiment on the highest temperature. Because on lowest temperature nothing will happen, so we have to be serious and objective about the device, and the experiment, the right experiment, must be done on the maximum temperature. Now, first of all, we have to auto-detect the atomizer, so I unlock Proteus. Let's say that this is a Proteus. It locks itself. I put atomizer, and now I will unlock it and wait for the auto detection function. I hope the auto detection will not burn wick. I don't think so, because the temperature is low. I show you how wick looks now and how wick will look after I push the button. Let's wait for the auto detection. Μαρία, κάνω βίντεο. Θα σε πάρω εγώ. You saw a delay on the blinking red light because the first phase stopped and the second phase started until the wire is detected the right way, detect the room temperature and all the stuff. You see the orange light open, that is that the auto detection function is finished, and now we can vape. Let's see in what stage of temperature we are. You see we are at the highest temperature. To show you again what I mean, if we want to go down, we are down. If we want to go up, full up, push the button until the button, the light stops. Now we are at 280 Celsius degrees. Let's push the button. Excuse me. Let's push the button. You see, nothing is happening. The wick show that is totally dry, and the quick red green lights open to show you that there's no liquid, and Vir will refuse to work. Let's do it again. Nothing. At the maximum temperature, you see that your wick stays totally dry. One more. Okay, your wick is totally white, totally clean, and not burnt at all. Let's put some liquid. To see what will happen. You see the green lights open because the liquid was burned, and when the whole liquid get burned, we stopped responding to not give you burnt taste at all, and to not give you a weak taste, and your wick is totally clean. Let's push it again. It vapes a little more because the liquid that was at the edges of the wick came to the center of the wick, and the wire find some liquid to burn. Let's push it again, and that's it. It stops responding. Your wick is still in perfect condition. We can put the tank too, so we will be able to vape and to see what will happen if we close or open the mouthpiece on GG atomizers. I want to show you this because I want to show you how you can control the power, the power of the electronic and the power of the battery via mouthpiece. On GG atomizers, when you open the mouthpiece, you feed more the wick, so VIR works on full power. And when you close the mouthpiece, VIR works in a way that you have the same temperature on your smoke, but you have small smoke. It's like you vaping in a lower step, but you don't vape in lower step, you vape at the exactly the same temperature, but with a small amount of smoke and still without burning a taste or burning your wick. Before that, I want to show you something else. How VIR works while the button is pushed, what will happen if you open the mouthpiece or if you put some liquid while you are vaping. I will put only one drop, push the button, vapes a little, now vapes slow. No, what I want to show you is the green lights were quicker than me. I want to show you how the smoke is reduced when there is no liquid on the wick, and how smoke is going much bigger when you when liquid comes to wake, even if you still have the button pushed. To do this, we have to put enough liquid, especially at the edges of the wake, so the center of the wake will be fitted always, but in a small quantity. And I will try to see when the liquid will be low, and I have to put more liquid to show you the difference on vaping at the same temperature, if the liquid is small or big on the coil. Let's try it one more time. You hear the noise. Green lights. Let's push it one more time. You see, the smoke is small. Now it's bigger. Bigger. Okay. Let's see the wick again to see if something happened to the wick. Wick is in an excellent condition. Now, let's put the tank, and I will take inhales while the mouthpiece is open or closed, to show you that there is no burn taste at all with beer. With beer, if you make the right setup, as I show you, it's very simple. You will never have a burn taste. You will just forget it.
Let's vape with the mouthpiece closed. That means that the wick feed it in with a very, very small amount of liquid to see what will happen. Let's do a direct inhaling. Green lights, that means and because the mouthpiece is closed, wick is doesn't get fed, so the green light, green blinks started appearing to show you that beer will refuse to work because it can't see any liquid on your wick. Now that we stopped vaping, a little amount of liquid went via the mouthpiece to the wick. And because there is liquid always at the edges of the wick, it went to the center. So I believe that I will be able to vape again for some seconds. You will notice that the smoke, because I push the button a lot of time, is getting smaller and smaller because the liquid on the wick is going smaller and smaller. Green lights. Okay, that's a very strange situation. It will not happen if you have the mouthpiece open. But I will show you on HG atomizers how quickly they respond, how quickly beer responds, even if it sees the smallest amount of liquid. Let's vape it again. Green lights. I will vape it until green lights will appear too often, and then I will open the mouthpiece. Anyway, because the tank is full, always a small amount of liquid escapes and goes to the wick. But at least I can show you the difference on the amount of the vape, the amount of the smoke when you open the liquid control. That means that the liquid control can control your smoke when you are vaping. On the atomizers, of course, only. Green lights again, and now let's open the mouthpiece. You see that it is very responsive, and I want you to hear the big noise that atomizer produces because it sees a lot of liquid. And I forgot to show you how the noise is when we close the liquid control. It's because we can't see any liquid, so your atomizer is not working with full power. Let me finish the liquid inside the tank. Locked, 15 seconds pass, unlock, and now I will let you hear the noise of the atomizer. It doesn't have enough liquid, the wick is not saturated because the mouthpiece is closed, so hear the noise. No, excuse me, 1 minute. Wick fed it again. Let's hear it now. Noise is much smaller. And now, no, it didn't stop. Let me see. Okay, let's unlock it. You hear the noise, it was big on the start, and now it got much lower. Let's open the mouthpiece and vape normal. You notice that, you didn't notice, you saw me inhaling, there was no burn taste at all. You saw how it stops when there's no liquid on the wick. And how it continuously work when it is liquid. The amount of liquid plays a big role on the quantity of smoke. A lot of liquid brings a lot of smoke, and small liquid brings small smoke. No burn taste. And the temperature is still steady. Even if the mouthpiece is closed and the smoke is very small, the temperature stays at the same levels. Let's go some steps down. Let's go 4 steps down. It is the recommended step for Proteus. That way you will have a long lasted battery life on Proteus because it can't handle for a lot of a big period of time the highest temperature, that is 280. Now we are at 240. Let's see how Proteus will vape. Now, if you keep your mouthpiece a very little open, Virgo will still work, Proteus will still work, but that way you save on Proteus, because it has a small battery, you will save battery life. A closed mouthpiece, what will happen? Not enough liquid, not a lot of liquid, enough, it will be enough, not a lot of liquid will go via the wick. So the battery will not be forced to give a lot of current. But it will still vape, of course, normally. You hear the noise. It's very big because the liquid control is open at about 0.5 millimeter. It's not open a lot, but the vape, the smoke and the heat is very big because of the temperature level. You can do direct inhaling without a problem, without fear of burn taste. Let's do it, and I will keep it for 15 seconds. Also, I will close the mouthpiece. I didn't keep it for 15 seconds. Anyway, I will try again. Liquid has nicotine inside, and I'm not sure that I will manage to do that. That was seconds direct inhaling. You saw that because the device is locked. Proteus and Vir have a 15 seconds lock time. We will unlock it and vape again. If you have a burn taste on Proteus, what is happening is a threat on the coil that will get red hot. That means two things. Or the legs of the coil are too big, because you made on GG atomizers a very thin coil, very thin, and the legs, the distance of the legs between the coil and the posts is big, very big. I show you on at the start of the video. Or because the wick doesn't touch all the threads of the coil, something difficult, as you see, because when you put a wick on the coil, it goes the most of the times or all of the times in the right way. I don't know what else to show you about Vir. It is an extremely well-built and healthy device. That was my purpose, to control temperature and to avoid poisoning our bodies with all this stuff, acrolein and acetaldehyde and all this. What I wanted to show you is how the noise will start be bigger while pushing the button and at the same time opening the mouthpiece. I will try to do that too, to see what happens when Vir sees more liquid on the wick. You hear the noise? Let's open it. The noise gets bigger because more liquid goes inside your wick. That's for now. If I remember something more, I will tell you. I wanted to show you with this video how safe you are with Vir, and you will not face any problems. Thanks for watching. Bye.